Hi, my name's Paul Sonner. I'm a violin instructor at Interlochen Arts Academy. And today, I'd like to talk to you about how I teach bow hold in my studio at Interlochen. I want to make it very clear, this is not the only way. I've just found it to be the most convenient as I prepare my students for their conservatory or university auditions. I often start with just a pencil if I'm not happy with the bow hand I'm seeing. And I take the pencil and I have some contact points that I try and make very clear for my student. A contact point to me in our studio is any part of our body that touches the instrument. And bow is definitely part of our instrument. A very important part is a contact point. So let's review these contact points. I'm going to start with the thumb. Right there, the tip. Not in the middle, not on the nail, not too high, not too low. Right there. And get that on the bottom. You don't want it flat. You don't want it too much this way, not too much that way. Approximately there. You want to avoid straightening your thumb out too much, a little bit of a curve. Index finger, you can pronate slightly towards the tip of your bow, okay? Drop it over the contact point in between these two joints. Simply drop 2-3 over, okay? Don't grab on really tight. If I turn it over, you can take a look at that and see index finger in between the joints. Not really that well defined on your middle finger and your ring finger and fourth finger on the tip. It's basically what it should look like. Okay, little bit away from the screw on your bow. I like to see about 1/4 inch there. What you want to try and avoid from the very start is no goose neck, okay, and no just grabbing on. No angling that way. It has to be towards the tip of the bow or the pencil. Like that. Why this is really good is because it's fairly easy to do. On the inside you can see there, and kind of nebulous on 2 and 3, and pretty much on the tip of your fourth finger. You can practice flipping it. Why it's really good on a pencil if you're working on your bow grip is because you can take it with you in between classes or anywhere, and you can just practice this simple exercise, flipping the pencil. Very valuable. All right, let's transfer those contact points to our bow. With your left hand, you could hold on up here somewhere on the stick. And once again, I'm going to take this contact point on my thumb. I'm going to put it where the frog meets the stick. I'm not going to put it all the way through. I'm not going to put it halfway through. I'm going to keep it just a little bit on the inside towards me as the contact point. And I'm making contact with both the frog and the stick. I'm going to pronate my hand slightly, drop my index finger onto the grip. 2 and 3, just let them lightly go over. Fourth finger, see now I'm a little close, so I'm going to move it up a little bit. Okay, and that would be acceptable. Everyone's going to be a little bit different. What you want to avoid right off is you don't want to grab on like that with the frog with your second and third finger. Maybe for some strokes, but for this exercise, just allow them to rest comfortably. Keep them nicely curved. Some kind of relation of third finger with the eye on your frog is okay. You don't want to cover it like that, but you also don't want to be really far away from it. Evenly spaced. And you can just hold it at level in front of you. You can straight arm. And a wonderful exercise is, let's see, so that's a little close to the screw. So I'd just have my student move it up a little bit. Okay? Straight out in front of you. See if you can keep balance and relax. You can practice rotating it all the way over. You can examine your contact points if you can see them there. Not really well defined on 2 and 3. Fourth, I'm definitely on the tip. First, between those two joints. Okay. Really good exercise from here is you can practice walking the stick all the way to the tip. And each step of the way, try and keep as beautiful a bow hand as you can, and then reestablish at the frog. There are other exercises. This is how I would begin. And that would be a really pretty well-established bow hand for our purposes to begin with. Good luck.